In this video, you're going to learn about three specific AI tools that are perfect for entrepreneurs, small business owners, freelancers, or anyone who wants to work with more efficiency. The first one is super simple and effective. The second one is going to help you if you have video content. And the third one is the one I'm most excited about using at the moment, and it can also be used in your personal life. So let's get straight into it. The first one is Otter AI. Now, I'm not going to go through this in depth because it's super simple, but it is actually adding some new features here, as you can see. So I'll leave a link to otter.ai and you can take a look at this in the description to see what these types of things are. But what it's mainly used for is the AI meeting assistant. So it plugs into your Zoom meeting, okay? Then it creates this transcript as you're talking. But the key part is the summary, as you can see on your screen now. So it creates these summaries with action items. Now that went through quite quickly, so I'm just going to go down here and show you again. So skip the tedious task of composing action item emails. So you can think about if you are on a sales call with somebody, then it can list these action items and also send you a summary of the meeting. If you're on a consultation with somebody, action items again for what you can discuss in the future. So instead of you taking notes through the Zoom meeting, this is going to do it for you. So you can think of all of these different things, all of these different meetings that you can have where it's going to give you a summary and these action items. Now, pricing is pretty good too. There is a free plan, and this is basically limited to the amount of time you can use on this. I've only used the free plan and never got into this, but if you're always on Zoom, then you might need to upgrade here. Now, you'll notice there's a big difference between the monthly price, $17, and the yearly price, $833. So massive difference with that. But that's number one, otter.ai. The next one is Opus Clip, which is actually opus.pro. Now, this is exactly what it says here. One long video, 10 viral clips, create 10 times faster. So what it's going to do is take long form formats like this one here, and then it's going to create what it talks about, viral short form videos. So if you want to create shorts from a podcast that you do or a long form video that you do, this is a great place to start. And I've used this in the past with various channels, and it has created some really good short form content. An Opus Clip is always adding new features like this, meet clip anything. So this is where you can use AI commands to then clip parts of the video. So for example, clip my exciting reactions to tasting shawarma. And then you can see here, it does that here. And this is just going to improve as we go forward. But a few features that we really like, it has this auto reframe, so it reframes the people. You can have one person or two people like this, so you can go back and forth when they're talking. You can do the animated captions. These are accurate, and you can also choose your style and then have each new clip in that style, in that template. That's what it says here, brand templates. And then also over here, you have AI B-roll. So you can put B-roll over your clips as well on the videos. And if we go to pricing, it's all about credits per month. So if you do one credit is 1 minute of video processing, 150 credits. So that's going to be $15 a month. So that's 2.5 hours worth of video per month. And then it gives you these features. And then also Pro, again, they like to get the yearly bill in here, is going to be this. Okay, so it's more credits and some B-roll features, etc. Now, there is a free plan, but it has a watermark. So that is Opus Clip or Opus Pro. Now this one, perplexity.ai, is one of my new favorite tools. So you'll look at the screen now and think, this looks like ChatGPT, it looks like Claude, it looks like Google Gemini, and it is very similar to those, except for I see this as more looking up real-time data and also factual information. And what it does is it goes to a variety of different sources across the web in order to create its responses. So I use this more for things like step-by-step advice about using a tool. I use it for, instead of Google at the moment, for the search engine. because what it's going to do is it's going to summarize the search results instead of you having to go to different websites. And I prefer this over the Google AI equivalent to that. For example, on the channel, Seth has made a video on Bolt, bolt.new, and this is a very popular new tool. I was a little bit confused about how to deploy it, so what you can do is put it in here. How can I deploy an app built on bolt.new? Okay, so what it's going to do is use these different sources. Bolt.new, source one. Build anything with bolt.new, YouTube, Reddit, and then these other sources here, down here. So you can say show all, and it's going to have these sources on this side so you know exactly where it's coming from. And then what you can do also is you can say, I want to exclude these ones, remove source from here, for example. But if we go back to the result, it tells us exactly what to do here. So it says, choose a deployment platform. Bolt.new supports deploying to Netlify out of the box. This allows you to easily host your web application. And then it goes through it step by step about how to do this. And it says, important to note that while Bolt.new makes it easy to deploy web applications, it's primarily designed for web apps and not for native mobile applications. So, and then down here, you have related, or you can ask follow-ups to this. And then another personal question you can ask it, and I'll just type this out real quick. Okay, I want to visit Rome, but don't want it to be too hot or cold, and I don't want it to be at peak tourist season. Also, I want flights to be as cheap as possible flying out of New York City. When is the best time or times to go? And as you can see, it's done it super quickly, and it's got the sources from Reddit, Celebrity Cruises, Head Out, and all these different sources, including Wikipedia. So it says, based on your preferences, the best time to visit Rome will be during the shoulder season of spring, mid-March to May, or autumn, mid-September to November. Moderate weather, fewer crowds, lower prices. But it also gives some other information here about, like, Easter can be busy due to religious visitors. Autumn option, for the cheapest flights from New York, consider booking 2 to 3 months in advance, being flexible with your travel dates, etc. So you can see here, this is factual information that's going through and taking it from all of these sources and putting together something that would take somebody a long time to research if you're just going through Google. So those are the three AI tools that we love at the moment. If you want to learn how to build apps, websites, and anything else using no-code and AI tools, then go to nocode.mba, where you can see here we cover the most in-demand no-code and AI tools, practical courses all in one membership. So we have all these courses that you can see on your screen now. Go to nocode.mba to learn more about that. And then also check out our latest videos on YouTube and be sure to subscribe on the YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.